Epstein has a motion to withdraw a judge, and it's a criminal matter, is that right?
Right.
Does the court, I know there's nobody else from our office here, I should probably stay. It's case number 0613450, State of Oregon versus Peter Davis.
Okay, well, Mr. Bernstein, you want to give me a little bit of the background here then?
Well, Your Honor, without getting into too many details about...
Why don't you give, Mr. Davis some paper for his gum so that we won't be distracted by his chewing efforts there.
Your Honor, without, again, going into details that the bar might feel our attorney-client correspondence and whatnot. Essentially, Mr. Davis has made certain demands, requests on how I go about trying to defend him. I've tried to explain to him that he will make ultimate decisions, but he doesn't tell me how to defend him. He basically told me either I defend him the way he wants or I'm to be fired. We tried to continue this discussion on the phone after a meeting in my office. I allowed him, as his request, not to interrupt him, let him finish. He did not give me the same courtesy. So essentially, after telling me that if I wasn't going to defend him the way he wanted, I was to be fired and he was going to contact the bar, I hung up on him. I immediately filed a motion. While my secretary was en route to filing the motion with the court, got a fax from him that said that pursuant to information from the bar, he was instructed to tell me to ask for a new court-appointed lawyer and to do that for him since he didn't know how to do that. I called back, left a message on the machine that said, I already did that. It's been filed before I even got your request. So other than that, I have nothing further. But as I've indicated, as far as I'm concerned, the relationship is not mendable.
Well, so what part of Mr. Bernstein's explanation about the relationship between a court-appointed attorney and the defendant did you not understand?
Your Honor, I understood.
Well, then what would we be doing here, then, if you actually understood it?
I asked, Mr. Bernstein told me what the DA's plea was for me and the direction it was going to go in. I said, Mr. Bernstein, I am not guilty. I have a mental illness that will explain this. And what happened in my house is something that my partner and I have lived with for 15 years. And he wasn't willing to hear it. So I got upset, and when he...
Let's just take this a step at a time, okay? So he probably wasn't willing to hear it because you don't have a mental disease or defect that would constitute a defense to criminal conduct. And so that may be a part of the problem is that I don't know when you say that, you have some mental illness. Obviously you're operating in the community, and so the likelihood that you've got some kind of a defense there that may be somewhat compromised, and of course the other part of that is that he has to tell you what the DA's offer is and how the DA sees the case, and of course obviously your partner, to the extent that you may have lived with this for 15 years, your partner called the police. The police got involved here. The police are in now, and so now this is no longer a matter between, you and your partner. This is now between you and the community at large. So you have to understand kind of that's our starting point. And so you can't simply just, tell the lawyer that, well, I have a mental illness. And so, therefore, this can't, proceed further or whatever the tenor of that was. But go ahead then.
There's never been domestic violence. There's not been a crime here. There's never been I was seizure. It's a seizure. It was a seizure. The officers didn't know it. They weren't listening when he called for an ambulance to get me to the hospital because I was seizuring. That's what was happening. Nobody's listening. So I have medical proof and doctors saying, yes, he is seizuring. This is what happens. There's a protocol for this, and we have a protocol. He has medication that is supposed to be immediately given to him so it'll stop it. Because I have brain seizures that make me break things. I don't hurt anybody. I'm trying to kill myself in this.
Yeah, well, Mr. Davis, you have to just stop.
What happened, and I was gay-bashed just a half an hour before the seizure.
Mr. Davis, just stop.
And nobody listened.
Mr. Davis, just stop. Just stop. Now then, I'm not sure what that had to do with anything here. I'm not sure what that had to do with anything here. Because, and the reason we're going through this is because, of course, if you are given a new lawyer, we're going to have the same problem with the new lawyer. We're going to have the same problem with a new lawyer if you are going to simply take the approach that since you believe that certain circumstances exist, that you believe, well, and your doctors, well, that's fine.
The evidence that he told,
now, are you going to interrupt? Are you going to interrupt me as well?
Sorry.
Are you going to interrupt me as well? Now, you have to understand that as I'm sure Mr. Bernstein tried to explain to you, is that you don't simply get to decide that your doctors have proclaimed you innocent of this charge. You don't get to make that determination. That's a determination made in court. So I'm sure, I am absolutely sure, that what Mr. Bernstein did was exactly what he had to do, and that is tell you that the DA's office view is different. The DA's office has filed this complaint and is intending to pursue this through trial. They have offered certain concessions by way of plea negotiation. If you do not want to take them, then that is fine. Then that is, you know, certainly your choice. And ultimately, this is, of course, your case, and so the outcome is entirely up to you in terms of which of a number of options are taken. But Mr. Bernstein has certain obligations both to you, but also to the court. And so, since he is the lawyer, it is up to him to determine essentially the legal implications here and provide you advice about that. And it is up to him to guard against what his conduct is in terms of his relationship with the court and this whole process. So, I don't know what exactly it is you're telling Mr. Bernstein to do that he is not able to do, and I don't need to know. But the problem here is, Mr. Davis, is that, of course, we're going to get another lawyer here because I'm not going to make Mr. Bernstein, I'm not going to make him, deal with you running to the bar, complaining about a bunch of stuff that you apparently do not understand. So I'm not going to make Mr. Bernstein deal with that. I'm not going to put him in that posture. But the problem is that unless you start, you know, stepping back from this situation and recognize that, you know, it may be crystal clear to you, and you may believe it is crystal clear to your doctors that you are absolutely without fault. The problem is the DA's office is of a different view. And the problem is that you are going to have to go through a court process for a determination to be made. And you don't simply just get to go to the end and, hey, everybody just fold up their tent and go away because I didn't do anything wrong. There is a process. Now that the police are involved and you are criminally prosecuted by the district attorney's office, there is a process. And so I'm very concerned about the fact that we are talking about here, for reasons that are entirely unclear to me, that your first step, the first conflict you have with Mr. Bernstein, you run to the bar claiming that there is ill deeds being done by your court-appointed lawyer. Now, because, of course, as I say, because we're going to give you another lawyer, who, of course, is going to be subject to the same restraints, professional restraints, that Mr. Bernstein operates within. And so we're going to be in the potential position of being in exactly the same spot. And we're not going to continue to simply just, you know, give you lawyers until you find one that is, you know, that is more to your liking generally, or one responsibilities. So if you want to hire your own attorney, of course, that will save us all a lot of, you know, time and energy here, because then the court won't have to be involved in that process. You can make whatever agreement. You can shop around and find a lawyer that you feel more comfortable with, or that you feel is more willing to do whatever you believe. And I'm not sure exactly what the source of your knowledge is about these criminal proceedings that would give you a better sense about the appropriate approach versus Mr. Bernstein, who's only been doing this for, you know, some 30-some years.